someone's briefing the newspapers about what's likely to happen, but you can't tell us what's likely to happen because you haven't collected all the data, which means you haven't actually got a plan yet. So the newspapers speculate furiously, and so would I if I'd been made slightly differently, I suppose, speculate furiously about what is and what is not likely to happen on Monday, because there's an absolute vacuum of clarity and leadership at the very top of the country into which all sorts of dangerous nonsense can move. And if you've got a little Groundhog Day feeling right now, you're right. I've been saying this for the best part of 2 months now. When there is no clarity and leadership at the top, it creates a vacuum into which absolutely anything can move. And we're still at it. That's what's so incredible. We're still at it. I would now rather have a Prime Minister stand up in front of the country and say, look, folks, God knows. We've absolutely carked it so far. We've got 400,000 gowns stuck in Heathrow. I am so sorry. We were so desperate to buy stuff. Turns out we did a deal with the Turkish equivalent of Derek Trotter. We've been flogged 400,000 dodgy gowns. I'm not even going to be able to get rid of them out the back of the Nelson Mandela Tower in the heart of Sunny Peckham. But forgive me. We just muffed it up. We were too desperate. And then he says, I don't even know whether we should be coming out of the lockdown. It can't carry on indefinitely. Some scientists say this, some scientists say that. I'm going to have to take a view on it. And I just want you to understand what lies behind the view I've taken. But I am really sorry about those gowns. Oh, and that statistician that I mentioned in PMQs yesterday, he's asked me to stop using his name in support of the idea that we shouldn't be making international comparisons. Yeah, that's me, the Prime Minister of the United Kingdom, standing up in Parliament, claiming support from a scientist, from a statistician, who had to take to social media to ask me not to cite him in support of what I was saying. That's where we are as a country. And we now look to this man to lead us out of the restrictions and the instructions that the lockdown entails. The man who led us into it in such a cack-handed fashion that some people still don't know what they are and are not supposed to be doing. The man who led us into something so weaker and looser than Spain and other countries, Italy even, that despite the fact that they were ahead of us and therefore sounding alarm bells and giving us warnings, we decided to do it after prevaricating and postponing and talking about taking it on the chin. We decided to do it in a half-hearted fashion that has still not properly cut through to parts of the country. He's the fella that we're going to trust with the loosening at a time when more people are dying every day than they were when we went into it. But hey-ho, tug that forelock, doff that cap, cheer old Boris Johnson and have a look at the baby pictures. What a magnificent time to be alive. Why am I in such a good mood? Well, I just looked at the front page of the Sun newspaper and as far as I can tell, something amazing and fantastic is happening and we should all be celebrating. Let's get it right, shall we? Happy Monday. Go out to exercise all you like. Sit in park 2 meters from your pals. Pubs, cafes, plan to open gardens. Front of the mail. Hurrah! Lockdown freedom beckons. What do you think is happening? 03456060973. I am going to suggest to you that the government, that Boris Johnson and Dominic Cummings, they haven't got a clue. What has happened today with these weird and often contradictory media briefings is that they're playing us just like they played Brexit. They're waiting to see what washes with the public, regardless of whether it's true or not. This is £350 million written on the side of a bus, but with death rates. What's going to work? What are they going to buy? What are they going to go for? What's going to make us look good? What's going to make the approval ratings better, regardless of reality? That's what we've done in Britain over the last 4 years. We've removed reality from the top of the things that matter. What matters is perception. What matters is polling. What matters is focus groups. What doesn't matter is facts. What doesn't matter is reality. What doesn't matter is evidence. This is just my theory. Feel free to pull it to pieces to your heart's content. But in order to do so, you're going to have to tell me what the plan is. Oh, we can't tell you what the plan is until Sunday. Then why the hell are newspapers being briefed about where we're going to be able to sit in pub gardens? Because there isn't a plan. And what will come out on Sunday will have been formed by this sort of audience research exercise that kicks off today with a bunch of supine and sycophantic newspapers effectively operating as opinion pollsters for a government that hasn't got a clue. And if you think I'm exaggerating, go and count those gowns at Heathrow.